Hey, what is up? It's Musmi here. Today I'm going to be talking about how to get the grenade launcher gold in Black Ops Cold War as quick as possible. Going to be giving some hints and tips of how to do each challenge and advice on how to play with the grenade launcher in order to actually get these challenges done as quick as you can. Now, the advice I'm giving is based on my own experiences of unlocking the grenade launcher gold. As part of a Dark Matter unlocking series that I'm doing on my channel, where the order in which I get the guns gold is determined by a random number generator, I was unfortunate enough to get the grenade launcher pretty early on in the series, but this just means that I'm able to show you guys how to get it gold as quick as possible and make your lives a lot easier. If this video does help you, then please do let me know in the comments, give the video a like, a subscribe, do whatever you want. Just let me know if you found it useful, or if you didn't, let me know why. Also, feel free to check out the RNG Camo Mastery series that I just mentioned. It's a lot of fun, something completely different. But let's get straight into the video now, and I'm going to give you some tips on how to get the grenade launcher gold. So here we are in the gunsmith. Now, the amount of challenges there are for this gun is pretty intimidating, seeing as it is practically useless. But that's why I'm here, to help you get this done as quick as possible, so you don't even have to think about it again. So starting off with the spray, this is just kill 30 enemies in multiplayer for the hardest one. I'm convinced somebody missed a zero off of this, because the next challenge is long shots, which is get 50 long shot medals. So why it's get 30 enemies when the next challenge is literally get more kills, I don't understand. But anyway, spray is super easy. You don't even have to worry about that one. It will just get done. So next up is long shots. Now, this is the one I had quite a lot of difficulty with. There's three main ones which are really hard on this gun, and long shots is one of them. The quickest way I found for getting this challenge done on this weapon is in Hardcore Nuketown. Now, Hardcore Nuketown is going to be your best friend for getting this gun done. You'll live there for a week, 2 weeks, however long it takes you, but basically you won't be leaving Nuketown for a while. As you can see on the screen, what you want to do is when you're at this end of the map, you want to line up your shot so you basically fire it from your own spawn practically into their spawn, or at least into one of the channels that they'll be coming through. This was the best, most consistent way I found for getting long shots. Literally, you just spawn, go there and spam that. If you run out of ammo, just run in and let the enemies kill you basically, and just repeat for the entire game. I think this challenge took about an hour and a half to do, just purely focusing on it, which isn't actually too bad for this gun. As you can probably see in the clips as well, there are a few other spots that worked for long shot. Up into the windows is quite good, or from the window out onto the long angle, that works quite well. It is a pain and there's no getting around it, but a piece of extra advice I would give is actually don't 100% focus on long shots. As soon as you unlock them, you want to unlock the psychedelic camo challenges first, which is at gun level 30. And this is because getting the double kills, it's just random. There's nothing you can really do to actually influence it. It's just you shoot your grenade and you hope for the best. So for that reason, what I found was when I was trying to get these long shots, I actually got quite a few double kills along the way. So you don't want to sit there, spend an hour and a half just focusing on long shots, and then when you get to double kills, you're like, shit, I've got to do this. And you're basically just stuck trying to do something that is completely out of your control. Whereas at least if you're trying to do long shots alongside it, it helps a bit. Like, it gives you actually a bit of purpose and you can see the progression going. So that's some advice. I would say max this gun's level out before you start focusing on certain challenges. But obviously, that's just my advice. If you want to focus on long shots straight away, go for it. So next we've got 2 kills without dying 20 times with both the kills coming from the grenade launcher. Now, a couple of days ago, I think it was the 8th of December, actually, they nerfed this challenge. It used to be get 3 kills without dying, which I thought that would be really hard, but it actually isn't that bad. So the fact they've nerfed it to 2 and not nerfed like long shots is pretty crazy to me. This will just happen as you're leveling the gun up. You don't need to focus on it too much, especially now it's 2 kills. 1 double kill counts for one of these challenges, so that's really not that bad. Destroying 50 enemy equipment, score streaks, or vehicles in multiplayer, the best way to do this is just stick engineer on as soon as you unlock this challenge if you weren't using it already, and just play with the gun. And whenever you see someone put down a field mic or whatever, just go over and kill it. This will get done pretty easily, and you can just kind of do this alongside leveling the gun up, which is really nice. Next up, now, this one is a pain. Shoot and kill 50 enemies taking cover from you in multiplayer. Again, my advice is don't only focus on this until you've got your gun to max level. Then once you are at max level on the gun, see how many of these you've got. And then if you've got quite a few to get, or if you've just got a couple, a really good way of getting these kills on enemies who are behind cover. Now, this was actually explained to me by a subscriber who gives me so much support. He's an absolute legend. He's called Grandpa's Weed. You could probably find him in the comments. I'm sure he'll be there. He actually explained this to me. So if you go into Fireteam Dirty Bomb and you down an enemy with whatever gun you want, what you then do is you put out the grenade launcher, stand behind a tree or a building or whatever, and then just hit the enemy with the splash damage from the grenade launcher. As long as your last hit on them was with the grenade launcher and you're behind cover or you can't see them, that will count as a long shot. So doing that is a great way to focus on getting this challenge done, and it doesn't take too long. And playing Fireteam Dirty Bomb is actually quite fun, I've found. It's certainly more fun than playing Hardcore Nuketown, I'll tell you that for free. The next challenge, now this one, I personally think is the hardest, because again, it's completely out of your control. You've got to destroy 3 score streaks or enemy vehicles in a single game 10 times. So this is obviously one for combined arms, meaning you can leave Nuketown for a bit. I've actually found that Crossroads is better than Armada, because more people like to use the tanks, but the tanks are actually not that hard to kill. So the best piece of advice I can give, and you should be seeing it on screen now, is if you weaken the tanks with a Semtex, it does about 60% of their health. Then shoot it a bit with your primary. It also helps to put on the barrel that gives extra damage against vehicles. And then when it's down to about 20% health, then pull out the grenade launcher, shoot the tank, it dies. Pretty simple. And you can do all of that in maybe 8 seconds, I would guess, of just chucking the grenade, shooting it a bit, pulling out the grenade launcher, bang, vehicle destroyed. This also works against the big boats in Armada. Just get the grenade on, weaken them up, finish them with a grenade launcher, shoot them with your primary if you need to. Again, have engineer on, because then you can see as soon as somebody gets in a vehicle, you can just track it down and go for it and try and get the destroy. Obviously, when you see someone get on a jet ski or one of the snowmobiles, you can one-shot them with a direct impact with the grenade launcher. So do make sure you're trying to get them as much as possible, because they are the easiest ones to do, but people don't use them as much, which is kind of annoying. Also, if an enemy's in a vehicle and they get out, don't just ignore it. If you destroy it within 1 or 2 seconds of them getting out, it still counts as a destroy, which is actually really useful. So when somebody gets out of a vehicle, do try and get that finishing blow on it, as long as you're quick. Also, you can destroy score streaks. The only score streaks you can actually really destroy with this is the RCXD and the Sentry Turret. The Sentry Turret is far more common than the RCXD, so if you ever see one pop up when you are trying to destroy the other vehicles, do go and kill it, because they are basically just a free count towards this. This challenge took so long. Hopefully, if you follow that advice, it will get you there quicker. And finally, we're on double kills. Now, like I said, this one's pretty much out of your control, but if you unlock it as quick as you can, you do some long shots, hopefully you'll get maybe 10 or so. Then you go off, you do your score streak and vehicles. If you're lucky, you might get a couple of times where there's 2 enemies in a boat or 2 enemies on a jet ski, snowmobile, whatever. And you might get a few more double kills doing that. And then basically you just try and clean up all the challenges and hopefully you get all the double kills in that time. If not, you've just got to play Hardcore Nuketown, go back there and hope for the best, really. The only specific advice I can give for the double kills is when you are spamming the grenade launcher on Nuketown, do focus on the high traffic areas. So for example, coming out of the garage, coming out of the buildings, or sitting on the windows on the top floor, just focus on spamming those areas and you're bound to eventually get some double kills. This one is the hardest challenge, so don't get too frustrated if it does take some time. But hopefully by unlocking it straight away and then focusing on the other challenges, you might make a significant amount of progress on this challenge. And then that's it. You will have your gold grenade launcher. And oh my god, is it a good feeling. My reaction to when I unlocked it was just so good. It was just such a sense of relief knowing that I don't have to touch this thing again. At the same time, it's pretty cool to have, because I know not many people are going to have this gun gold. And to be fair, it's probably not actually the worst looking gold gun in the game, which is quite nice. So if you do want to get your grenade launcher gold, do follow those tips and it will help you significantly. I wouldn't have known to give those tips if I hadn't learned the hard way doing it myself and picked up some kind of little hints and tips along the way. So I'm sure my advice will help you out and help you get this gun quicker. If you are a bit of a sadist and you want to watch my struggle whilst I was getting this gun gold, then I'll put a link to the episode of the RNG Camo Mastery series that I get the gold gun in. To be honest, it is actually pretty fun just watching my pain as I'm trying to get this gun done. Maybe that's something to watch alongside you playing whilst you're on Nuketown. But as ever, if you've enjoyed the video, please do like and subscribe and let me know how you found it in the comments below. I'll see you next time.